Bristol Community College, Mathematics with Dean Avedikian, Math 131, Elements of College Mathematics, Section 5.2, Problem 1. This is Section 5.2, Problem 1. It says John is 28 years old. He invests $35 every week at 13% compounded weekly. How much will he have by the time he's 65, which is a typical retirement age? That's why I chose that number. And 35 a week is not a huge amount to spend. A lot of people spend that much on coffee. If you smoke, it'll be more than that. It's not a huge amount. And you'll see it'll amount to something pretty substantial. So this is the annuity formula, because in this section, it's either annuity or sinking fund. Annuity, you know how much you're saving, and you calculate the end amount. And the other one, you know the end amount, you calculate how much you save regularly. So this, we know how much we save regularly, we'll figure out what the end amount comes out to. So the formula is A equals P times some brackets, and in the brackets you have 1 plus R over M to the M times T power minus 1 in the numerator, and then in the denominator R over M. So let's fill that in. A, the final amount, equals P. Now, P, again, is not really for principal. You can think of it that way. It's for period rent. It's how much you save on a regular basis. And it's the $35. And in the brackets, in the top, we're going to have in parentheses 1 plus R over M. So that's 1 plus R. The rate as a decimal is 0.13. You have to write it as a decimal. M, the number of times compounded per year. Now, if we're doing weekly compounding, M will be 52, because there are 52 weeks in the year. Close the parentheses. We're going to have an exponent now, M times T. M is 52 for number of times compounded per year. And for T, a lot of people would put 65, but that's wrong, because you're not saving for all 65 years, because John doesn't start saving until he's 28. So from age 28 to age 65 is a 37-year span. 28 plus 37 more gets you to 65. And then don't forget, in the numerator, there's also a minus 1. I do occasionally forget that. Then in the denominator, you have R over M. So R, again, the rate as a decimal is 0.13. M, number of times compounded per year, is 52. And I'll close up those brackets. And typically what you have is the same decimal that's going to turn out to be a decimal in the numerator and denominator. In the numerator, there's a 1 in front of it, but not in the denominator. So let's start working out the computation. I'll clean up the parentheses a little bit, calculate my exponent, and start working this down. So A equals 35 times some brackets. Now in the brackets, I know I'm going to need my calculator. In the brackets, we have 1 plus 0.13 divided by 52. That's 0.0025, and I'm going to add 1 to it, so it's going to be 1.0025. Now again, I know that 13 over 52 is 1/4 from playing cards. There's 13 of each suit. If you're not comfortable with that, or you think it's 0.0025 and you're not sure, just do it on your calculator. With your calculator, you would do 0.13 divided by 52 equals, and the calculator will tell you it's 0.0025. And then when you do plus 1, it'll be 1.0025. And again, notice you're going to have that same decimal in the denominator, but without the 1 in front of it. And now the parentheses will have an exponent. 52 times 37, if I'm doing my math right, I think it's 1,924. That I'll definitely check. And there's a minus 1 at the end. So before I go any further, let me do 52 times 37 is, 1,924. So now, at this point in the problem, what you need to do is deal with that big exponent of 1,924. So you have to do 1.0025 times itself almost 2,000 times. Again, without a scientific calculator, not something you can do easily. So I'm going to go A equals 35 times some brackets. And I'm going to have some result for that massive exponent I'm going to do. There's going to be a minus 1 after it, and a 0025 in the denominator. So now, to calculate this 1.0025 to the 1,924th power, I'll use my calculator and I'll do 1.0025, press the exponent button on my calculator, enter the 1924 equals, and the result of that enormous exponent is 121.9971278. And again, I'm going to let all the decimals just go through the computation for now, and I'll eventually round it at the end to two places after the decimal for how many cents. So now, when I subtract the 1, the 121.99 something is going to go down to 120.99 something. That I can do. So A is 35 times some brackets, and now on the top of the brackets you have 120.9971278 after you deal with the minus 1 that was there from the previous step. Same denominator, 0025. So I have the 121 on the screen of my calculator now. Let me just go minus 1 so it'll say what I'm going to have to deal with, the 120.9971278. And to finish the work in the brackets, I'm going to take the 120.9971278 that's on the screen of the calculator, divide it by 0.0025. And the calculator tells me that it is 48,000 and something, and it's still times the 35 in front. So what we have now is A equals 35 times, and what I just said is 48,000 and something is specifically 48,398.85113. And again, I'm just going to let all those decimals stay for the time being. So to finish the problem off, I'm going to take the 48,398.85113 and multiply it times the 35 that's in front of the brackets. And since the 48,000 is on my calculator screen now, I'm just going to go times 35. And now the answer comes out to 1,693,959.79. It actually just winds up having two places after the decimal. And if you count up the digits, that's well over $1 million. $1,693,959.79. From saving only $35 a week, but over a very long period of time, 37 years, and 13% involves some risk. You wouldn't get it every year, some years it would go down, but it gives you an idea of how an insignificant amount each week over many years can add up to a very significant amount at the end.